Alright, welcome back. Beautiful music there by Carlos Kiba. Now, like I told you, the morning today, we want to learn more about the beautiful game of chess. Of course, a lot of people think it's very complicated, and like I said, it's not the political chess, because there are also pawns in politics, king, queen, come on, you know. But today, we want to learn more about chess and some of the benefits and what it can help you achieve as well. So I'll allow Duncan to, first of all, okay, I've already said his name, but you can introduce yourself and then pass the mic around for everybody else to do the same.
Yeah, my name is Duncan Apio, and I'm a chess player, and I'm here with a team of some of the top players in the country, and this is Milton.
I'm Milton Kihara, a two-time and 18 national champion, and also the managing director, Epitome Chess Academy.
I'm Sembe Mutua. I work with Mini Chess Kenya, an ECD program for kids studying in South Africa, and today we're also doing it in several schools in Kenya.
Mm-hmm. Right, we should have started with the lady, actually. I should leave all of you.
You're forgiven. I'm Anne Kono. I'm also a chess player, and I play for our national league team called the DB Bishops.
All right.
Yes. I'm Kennedy Gishero. I'm a chess trainer at KBA School in Maziwa. I'm also a chess player at TUK, that is the Technical University of Kenya. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
All right. Cool. So I guess you can, first of all, we just talk about chess. You have a live, this is not life size. Is it not a life size?
Yeah, this is the life size.
Life size, yeah. So. Life size chess board and the pawns and everything are here. So I guess first, you just tell us about the simple rules in a chess game.
Okay, in a chess game, we have six pieces.
Okay.
So each piece has its own rule of movement, and as a person plays, those are the rules that we observe during the game.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So we can teach the country one by one. It's a very easy game to learn.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay, I'll need Milton to get us the rook.
Rook.
Yeah. Now this is the rook. I think you can show it to the camera.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that is the rook or the castle. Yeah, you know a castle is where the king lives.
Yes.
Yeah, but we call him the rook.
Mm-hmm.
In the chess game, he's like a person.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so on the board, Milton can show us also how the rook moves.
Mm-hmm.
I think we put him on rank 4. Yeah, so that's the rook.
Mm-hmm.
And
so it can move.
Yeah, rook. The rook moves in ranks and files. So now he's on rank 4, and he's on file E. So mm-hmm. on the board, you can see it's labeled. There's the E, A to H, and there's 1 to 8.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So the rook
in diagonal.
Yeah, yeah. From end to end.
End to end.
Yeah.
Right.
Milton can show us how the rook moves slowly.
So when delayed, it can move.
Oh,
yeah.
Sorry, just
give me a moment. Yeah. It can move here. It can also move here. It can also move here. It moves in an additional sign.
Ah, okay.
All right. So that is the rook.
Mm-hmm.
You see, it's a very simple movement.
Right.
Yeah. So we have two rooks on the board.
Mm-hmm.
They're usually at the starting point,
mm-hmm.
on the end and end. We have two rooks for both sides.
Mm-hmm.
So it's the white kingdom fighting the black kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
No pun intended.
Yes, no pun intended. All right. The next piece we have is the knight or the horse.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's the knight or the horse.
Mm-hmm.
And he's the soldier on the horse.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think you've seen them on the movies.
Mm-hmm.
The soldier that's seated on the horse and riding.
Right.
Yeah, so that's the represented by the knight.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So who are watching, who watch Game of Thrones, that is Sir Jaime Lannister.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. All right, so Milton on the board, you can show us how the knight moves. He moves, he usually moves in an L. So from that point,
mm-hmm.
he moves 3 squares forward and 1 side.
Mm.
Yeah.
So L.
Forming an L.
All right.
Yeah.
L either way, right?
Yes.
Multidirectional.
Yes. And the knight also is the only piece that's allowed to jump on top of the other pieces.
Ah, okay.
You can see all these other pieces
mm-hmm.
are behind the pawns. These are the pawns.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So those other pieces cannot come out until the pawn comes off the way.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So but
the knight can.
Yeah, the knight is allowed to jump on top there.
All right.
Yes. Yeah. So the next piece is the bishop. The bishop, we have two bishops.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So the bishops represented the bishops of Europe, I think,
mm-hmm.
when they were really powerful people.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. They were the ones who were giving the crowns to the king.
Right.
Yeah. So we have two bishops.
Mm-hmm.
I think Milton can show us the bishops. Yeah. So those are the bishops. Yeah. So we have two bishops.
Mm-hmm.
And as you see on the board, we have two colors. We have the white colors and the black colors.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so these two bishops usually stand on each different color.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and one is not allowed to come out of the
mm-hmm.
color that he started from.
Right.
Yeah, so those are the rules of the movement of the bishop.
Mm-hmm.
So Milton, you can show us how the bishop moves. Maybe an opening after an opening. I'll just open the pawn. Yeah, and
yeah,
you can see the bishop moves in a diagonal.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it's a very simple movement. Yeah, so that's how essentially how the bishop moves.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's the white, the light colored bishop,
okay.
And then we have the dark colored bishop. Yeah, the dark colored bishop moves in the dark diagonals.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. Yeah, so that's essentially how the bishop moves.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So now it just moves the dark
and the dark
diagonal, like you said.
Yes.
So it can't, the dark one can't go to a white.
It can't, it's not allowed to jump on the other color.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. So infringing, that will be infringing the rules
mm-hmm.
of the movement of that piece.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
All right.
So the next piece we have is the queen. The queen, as you can see, she's taller than the rest.
Right.
Yeah, but there's just one piece taller than him.
Mm-hmm.
So the queen is the most powerful in this game. She can move like the rook. Remember how we've shown how the rook moves?
Yes.
So Milton, you can show us how the queen moves. She can move from side to side
mm-hmm.
on the ranks. And she can also move like a bishop. On a light colored, when she's on a light colored,
mm-hmm.
and when she's on a black, dark colored square, mm-hmm. she can move like a dark bishop.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's how the bishop, the queen moves.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. The next one we have is the king. He's taller, he's the tallest piece.
Right.
Yeah. The king represents the person playing, actually.
Okay.
Yeah, so he represents your life. So
this is Milton.
That's Milton.
Okay.
So Milton's job is to command his army
mm-hmm.
to make sure the army captures the other king.
Right.
Yes.
The aim of the game is to capture the king. Right.
The opponent's king.
But the queen is always more powerful.
Yeah, the queen.
In the moment.
Yeah, the queen is like a soldier when mm-hmm. she's out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so she's very powerful. When she's on the board, she can move a great number of squares and the other pieces.
Right.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. So I guess how do you let's say score points in this game?
Okay, in this game we usually capture the king.
Okay.
Yeah, so all these soldiers, their job is to capture the other king.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so the other king is supposed to use his soldiers also to make sure they've captured this other king.
Mm-hmm.
So whoever succeeds in doing that mm-hmm. is the winner of that particular battle in that game.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so the king, you can show us how the king moves. Mm-hmm. So the king moves just like the queen,
mm-hmm.
but he moves one step at a time.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
The people who know in it a draft.
Oh, yes.
So is it like that? Like okay, unachapa mtu unachukua yake.
Yes, yes. You can show us how. Yeah.
So, that happens,
so that's
right?
A pawn.
Mm-hmm.
You can see a pawn capturing the other pawn.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So these are foot soldiers.
Okay.
The pawn is not allowed to move back.
Okay.
His job is just to move forward towards the enemy.
Right.
Yeah. So a pawn has captured the other pawn.
Mm-hmm.
And this pawn is the tiniest piece, is the weakest piece, but when he reaches the end of the rank, mm-hmm. he's promoted to another piece. Mm-hmm. Can even be promoted to a queen.
Right.
Yeah. Okay. So that's the advantage of the pawns.
So in the normal game, right? What we're doing is just for fun, recreational rather, guys. Unachukua tu hadi ufike checkmate. But how do you actually get the points? Like, if I take your queen, do I get more points? Like a certain number of points, 2, 3, 7, 9.
Yes. So the queen, the bishop, the knight, the rook, the king, and the pawns, all of them have points.
Okay.
So the queen has, being the most powerful piece, she has 9 points.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So on the board, if the other opponent has 9 points over you, that means he has enough forces to overcome your soldiers. Yeah. So in chess, you have to do that calculation.
Mm-hmm.
That's why it's a very useful game in developing the calculation ability,
right.
The mathematics.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So the queen having 9 points,
mm-hmm.
you wouldn't exchange him with another piece like the rook.
Right.
Yeah, because that one will be 9 minus 5.
Mm-hmm.
The rook is 5 points.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So we need to always be careful not to exchange a more powerful piece
mm-hmm.
with a lesser piece.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that gives you the logic of measuring what will I do if I move there, or what will the opponent do
right.
if I put a piece where it can be captured there,
mm-hmm.
lesser piece.
Right.
Yeah, so it's like being very careful when mm-hmm. moving on the board
right.
against the squares
mm-hmm.
that the enemy soldiers control.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Right. And also, you know, talking about it competitively, I guess we'll start with you. And when did you decide to do it competitively, and what benefits has it had for you to have the mic here?
I was introduced to chess when I was in Form 1.
Okay.
That is back in 2007.
Mm-hmm.
Karima Girls. Our principal was very interested in the game.
Mm-hmm.
Competitively, I started equally in high school.
Mm-hmm.
We'd go for tournaments. With the high school also. Then after high school, then I got to play the bigger tournaments and other qualifying tournaments. So basically that is how I've been into chess.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Advantages, chess is addictive in a positive way.
Mm-hmm.
It also broadens your mind
mm-hmm.
to so many ideas. It also gets you connected with so many people at different levels. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So the more you play chess, the more you get exposed to outside world. Yeah. So basically, it's more of an opportunity.
Right.
Yes.
All right.
Yeah.
And also, some are asking, just even as we wind up because of time, when you're introducing me, you mentioned the different groups you represent. So if somebody wants to get in touch with you and get into this group, maybe you can tell us how they can get in touch with you. So how would you?
Oh, okay. So how you can get in touch with us, that is this group we call the Chess Academy.
Mm-hmm.
We are a group of 5 trainers. And how to get in touch with us is, maybe you can just write down the number very fast. Yeah, it's an easy way.
Or for maybe chess only, for chess only.
For chess only.
Yeah.
Yeah. 0704 866 291.
Mm-hmm.
That's one way you can get in touch. And then most of the time we do play chess games at various places like Survey. We have the Kenya Chess Club, the KCB grounds where we play chess most of the weekends. Mm-hmm. So that's where you can find us also. And we have been playing for quite some time. We play the Kenya Chess League. That's where you've been that.
All right.
Maybe we shall communicate more.
Yeah.
Thank you.
All right.
You can also get in touch with us by texting me for chess purposes only. So 0706 768 023. That's my number. And also on Facebook, my tag is Milton Chess GM. On Instagram, Milton_Chess. I've partnered with various chess clubs in Kenya. I've partnered with many chess. I've also partnered with Terian Chess Academy.
Mm-hmm.
I've also been into Anchor Chess Club. I've also been into Nairobi Chess Club, Chess Academy.
Mm-hmm.
I've also been into Nairobi Chess Club. and I also have a chess, a school of chess by myself. Mm-hmm. It's called Epitome School of Chess. We are just starting it, and it's gonna be good for the youth and for the kids. Ours is to promote chess, mm-hmm. and teach the way chess, like how chess connects with life, our daily life. We also coach. We do a lot of private coaching, and also we also coach in schools. You can also you can get more information from the tags.
All right, and finally, yourself, that's your camera right there.
As I mentioned earlier, my name is Sembe Mutua from Mini Chess Kenya, founded by the former Chess Kenya chairman Githinji Hinga. We are one of the biggest chess franchises in Africa, in partnership with the mini chess franchise around the continent. In Kenya, currently we have 768 students in about 20 schools, and our programs are specially tailored for early childhood development. That mm-hmm. is 5 years to 9 years.
Mm-hmm.
At the moment, we have several schools: Logos Christian School, we have Brookside Preparatory, we have Nairobi Academy, Breban Imani, and many, many other schools on that list.
All right.
You can get in touch with us by going to our website, www.minichess.co.ke. Thank you.
All right. So let's say thank you so much for coming through. Of course, we'll, there's still so many questions. I know I've been told there are a lot more questions on Twitter, 42 and on Twitter. So we'll probably organize another session where you can come and just walk us through some of that, especially about the competitive angle of it. But again, thank you for making time for us. Of course, we're going to take a short break. Coming up next, it is Dr. Wale Akinyemi, and it is all about Inspirational Monday. And today, like I told you, my little thing, find out next.